Buckle up, Buttercup. It's Pittsburgh Sports Talk. It's a beautiful day in Pittsburgh. We haven't seen weather like this since, well, the Stadium Series game against the Philadelphia Flyers when it was 80 degrees before the game on Saturday. Hey, guess what? Your Pittsburgh Penguins are laying waste to the new wannabe kids on the block, the Smashville Predators. Come up here with a bad attitude and thought the trade from Montreal with Subban was going to make them, well, worthy and contenders for Lord Stanley's Cup. Two nights at Igloo, well, that kind of changed their minds, regardless of them throwing catfish, tuna fish, whatever they want to throw on the ice at the Pittsburgh Penguins, including PK Subban, is not going to stop the current Stanley Cup champions from, well, marching down Lord Stanley's Road one more time. Speaking of flying octopuses, flying penguins, and flung catfish onto the ice over at the Igloo, your men in blue, Pittsburgh police, have been hard on the case to figure out exactly who threw that catfish the other night. Let's take a look.
In the criminal justice system, seafood-based offenses are considered especially heinous. In Pittsburgh, the dedicated detectives who investigate these fish felonies are members of an elite squad known as the Catfish Victims Unit. These are their stories.
The Predator fan snuck in a catfish here, Doc.
And he used in the catfish's act. He's our man.
He's a predator. This kid has no idea.
Right, because predators know who to pick on. Go, now.
You need a warrant, counsel?
I'll get you one. Just go.
Don't even try, Baczynski. We know you catfished the boy.
All right, let's take a look back at game one footage because it was an unbelievable game. Who would have thought that the most powerful offense, Malkin, Crosby, and the new kids on the block, Sherry and Gensel, would have only had, I don't know, a handful of shots against the Predators in game one. But still, the boys got it done.
The Penguins are the defending champs. The Predators are here for the first time. Game one of the Stanley Cup Finals has arrived at PPG Paints Arena in Pittsburgh. The two teams split convincing wins in the regular season. Penguins forward Patrick Hornquist returns for game one after missing six games with an upper body injury. Predators captain Mike Fisher dresses after missing the last two games of the Western Conference Finals.
He peels off, but his pass is blocked and taken on by Forsberg. Back to Subban, moving in and shooting one. It scores!
Pittsburgh is challenging that the play was offside prior to the goal.
If his toe is on the ice when that puck is completely over the blue line, that is an onside play. That's what they're trying to determine. To me, it looks like the play should stand and it's a good goal.
After video review, it was determined that the play was offside, therefore no goal.
And around behind it comes now for Gensel. Down to the ice was Hornquist, taken along by Gensel. First power play coming up, but it's a delayed call right now. Daly, a shot that floated wide. On this delayed call, that empty six attackers for the Penguins.
There might be two penalties here, Doc. And James Neal's got the other one. Well, that's not a good penalty at all by James Neal.
Meanwhile, it comes back to Daly. Daly walks it on across, hands on to Malkin, fires, scores! The puck, move yourself. All of a sudden, there's some space. Net front presence off the glove of Rene. He can see it all the way. That's when you gotta have a stop, and it ends up in the back of the net. Back deeper, it is Dumoulin, fed it behind for Crosby. Right back outside of the net. Scores! Sherry!
Brian Dumoulin keeps this play alive. And then an incredible pass by Chris Kunitz, the guy that is filling in for Brian Dumoulin, and Connor Sherry gets his first of the playoffs.
And a good challenge that came from Pecorine. Sent right back onto Bonino, gains the zone again. Bonino one-hands it in front.
Watch Nick Bonino, a one-handed shot off the stick of Pecorine and then off the right knee of Matthias Ekholm.
Worked on by Dumoulin, and around it comes down for Ryan Ellis. Ellis guides it back, and it's Subban with it there.
Ellis a drive. He scores! Ryan Ellis, and it's 3-1. Little pitch and catch here. Subban to Ellis. There's the screen from Arvidsson, and the Predators are on the board.
And a story of a shotless period, first time in team playoff history for the Penguins. Watch there by Cullen. Punched across. Yarncroke's shot fought off there by Matt Murray. Yarncroke with it again. Trying to get it through. It's Josi with it. Murray's one. Score! And it is 3-2.
The quick shot, a redirect off of Colton Sissons. Doesn't look like there's a distinct kicking motion. Off the knee, off the shin pad, a good goal.
Watson goes back for this one, and he gets there. Watson closed off by Mata. Pulls around behind, steps in front, and a shot, score! Goodrow has tied the game at 3-3.
Look at a play here by Austin Watson. He beats two Penguins. Here comes Goodrow. He beats Matt Murray between the legs. But this is outstanding effort from Austin Watson.
Pass comes across now to Josi. Tried to fly it on, but could not. Pitched on back and carried in now by Gensel. He scores!
And the first shot on goal for the Pittsburgh Penguins in 37 minutes and 9 seconds. Gensel goes top shelf.
Around it curled over near. Nick Bonino popped up high. Punnett's shoveled it along, not out. Bonino able to step free. Lob one along. Score!
Good job by Chris Tunitz. Tunitz's hand goes up even before that puck goes into the net.
Into the back, Ellis. A shot jammed loose off of Neal. Cleared by Crosby. And that's it.
Jake Gensel's goal with 3:17 left in regulation is the game winner as the Penguins hold off a significant Nashville momentum switch in a 5-3 win in Game 1 of the Stanley Cup Final. Pittsburgh wins after nearly blowing a 3-0 lead, along with just 12 shots on goal and a 37-minute span without one. It's the fewest shots by a winning team in a Cup Final game in NHL history. Game 2 is Wednesday night in Pittsburgh.